Hello friends, this is Kick, and in today's episode we have a special purpose AI from China that is set to replace commanders in the future, ChatGPT-4, which has passed the Turing test for the first time. The X2 air taxi tested over Beijing. SpaceX unveiling a budget Starlink Mini satellite antenna. New tests of Northrop Grumman's MantaRay underwater drone. Elon Musk working on Tesla's fourth master plan. And NASA delaying the landing of the Boeing Starliner by 4 more days without explanation. All this and more right now, let's go. Let's start today's episode from China, where they have developed an AI commander capable of leading the People's Liberation Army in large-scale but currently computer simulations. The AI commander is the sole decision-making core for the entire operation, possessing full responsibility and authority. This is the highest declared role for artificial intelligence in military research, according to scientists. For comparison, the AI used by the US Army serves only as a virtual staff officer, providing decision support. The AI commander is programmed as an experienced strategist, possessing sound judgment, balanced and firm character. It can calmly analyze and evaluate the situation, is not prone to emotions or impulsive decisions, and quickly develops tactical and strategic plans based on past similar situations. Scientists also added a feature of forgetfulness to their military AI model to simulate real combat operations under human commanders more closely. Forgetfulness is implemented by limiting the size of the knowledge base used by the AI commander for decision making. When memory reaches its limit, some knowledge is erased. The AI commander allows for a large number of military simulations without human intervention. It identifies new threats, develops plans, and makes optimal decisions based on the overall situation when battles do not go as planned or results do not meet expectations. It also learns and adapts based on victories and defeats. This method has many advantages: ease of implementation, high efficiency, and support for repeated experiments. Researchers from the Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers decided to conduct a Turing test for AI models to determine if people can distinguish a human from artificial intelligence in conversation. The Turing test, first proposed in 1950 by scientist Alan Turing, evaluates how indistinguishable a machine's intelligence is from that of a human. To pass the Turing test, a system must be able to converse with a human and make them believe they're talking to another human. During the experiment, 500 people interacted with 4 interlocutors: a human, the 1960s AI program Eliza, GPT-3.5, and GPT-4. Conversations lasted 5 minutes, after which participants had to determine if they were talking to a human or AI. Participants identified GPT-4 as a human 54% of the time. Eliza, a system pre-programmed with responses but lacking a large language model or neural network architecture, was recognized as human only 22% of the time. GPT-3.5 scored 50% and the human participant scored 67%. Researchers say that machines, like humans, can come up with plausible justifications after the fact. They can be subject to cognitive biases, manipulated, and become increasingly deceptive. These factors make AI systems exhibit human weaknesses and quirks. This makes them more human-like than previous developments, which only had a set of pre-prepared responses. Scientists also argue that there are valid criticisms of the Turing test, which is overly simplistic. According to them, stylistic and socio-emotional factors play a more important role in passing the Turing test than traditional notions of intelligence. Let's move on. The flying car developed by AeroHT, a subsidiary of China's XPeng, made its first flight in Beijing. The X2 was demonstrated in the Daxing International Airport area in Beijing during the China International Economic and Trade Fair. The price of the low-altitude research aircraft AeroHT is not yet disclosed. In May, the X2 took off in Shenzhen, reaching a height of 30 meters and was fully autonomously controlled. This demonstration flight was preceded by a series of successful X2 tests in various conditions, including deserts, rivers, and coastal areas. The first flight of the X2 in China's capital took place after city authorities announced plans to create 3 main air routes for low-flying vehicles by 2027. The plans include using flying cars for purposes such as emergency rescue operations, logistics and delivery, tourism, passenger transportation, and more. The fifth-generation flying car, which made its first international flight in Dubai in 2022, does not produce carbon dioxide emissions. It is claimed to be a step forward in the pursuit of eco-friendly urban transportation. Earlier this year, the defense contractor Northrop Grumman unveiled a prototype underwater unmanned vehicle for long-duration missions called the MantaRay. The emergence of the Ray prototype marks the culmination of 4 years of work on a secret project commissioned by DARPA. Its goal is to develop a very large autonomous underwater vehicle suitable for long-term combat missions over long distances without human supervision. The result is a prototype vessel that can be launched only from a pier, not from a submarine or ship, and a hydrodynamic hull shape that truly resembles a manta ray, with a propulsion system system borrowed from a glider, allowing it to smoothly ascend to the surface and dive again. The movement is powered by two four-blade propellers mounted on the wingtips. In addition, we were shown how maneuverable the vessel is underwater and confirmed that it can descend to the bottom and remain in sleep mode to save energy. Dark Systems has introduced a new version of the Dogfighter K9 Gen 4 helmet designed for dogs. The model provides protection and offers the owner the ability to attach necessary equipment. The Gen 4 is a rubber helmet with wide goggles for better vision and eye protection. This is not the first helmet designed for dogs, but the advantage of the Dogfighter K9 Gen 4 is its modular design, lightweight, and compatibility with previous systems. The body includes mounts for flashlights, loudspeakers, and other gadgets. It can also be equipped with a system for protection against loud noises or a muzzle. The company also offers a mount for radios. Meanwhile, SpaceX has shown what the new budget Starlink Mini antenna looks like, which will be available for sale in a few months. Elon Musk reported that he is already using the new device. He noted that the installation of the antenna took less than 5 minutes and that it can be easily carried in a backpack. Musk believes that this product can change the world by providing access to high-speed internet anywhere. Additionally, Musk announced that the Starlink Mini would cost around $250-$300, which is about half the price of the standard antenna sold in the US for $489 after a recent price cut of $100. As for performance, Musk shared speed test results showing that the Starlink Mini provides a download speed of 100 mmapps and an upload speed of 11.5 Mbps with a latency of 23 milliseconds. The new antenna will be slower compared to the base model, but this speed will be sufficient for most everyday tasks, including streaming 4K video. SpaceX plans to release the Starlink Mini in selected regions around the world in a few months. Musk noted that the Mini could be an excellent budget option for backup internet in case of issues with the main line. And since we started talking about Elon, let's continue with him. Musk stated that he is working on the fourth master plan for Tesla. He promises it will be epic. The first and second Tesla master plans laid the foundation for achieving important company goals. In 2006, Musk published the first master plan, which included creating a sports car, using the profits to develop more affordable models, and introducing zero-emission energy sources. These goals were achieved through the Roadster Model S and Model 3 models. The second master plan was introduced in 2016. It coincided with the launch of Model 3 and the acquisition of SolarCity. The plan included integrating energy storage systems with solar panels and developing autonomous driving technologies. It also included the creation of new models such as Cybertruck, Model Y, and Tesla Semi. The third master plan published last year differed from the previous ones. Instead of specific products, it focused on transitioning the global economy to sustainable development through electric vehicles and renewable energy. However, some points of this plan, such as the development of an affordable Tesla model for $25,000, have been postponed indefinitely. Experts believe that the fourth master plan will focus on autonomous driving and robotics. This is confirmed by Tesla's recent actions aimed at transitioning to AI technologies. And what would Kik be without space news? NASA has announced that the experimental Boeing Starliner spacecraft with two astronauts will begin its descent to Earth only on June 22nd, 4 days later than the previously scheduled date. The reasons for the new delay are not reported. Details and weather forecasts will be announced at a briefing on Tuesday. Boeing is pleased with the new delay as it allows them to learn more about the spacecraft in docking mode with the ISS. Whatever the Boeing representative says, the Starliner spacecraft's helium supplies are limited. Helium is used to ensure the operation of the spacecraft's propulsion system. When they run out, which will happen no later than mid-July, the spacecraft will not fly anywhere. This means that the docking port will need to be freed much earlier, with time to spare for various emergencies. And there are plenty of them in the Starliner's first manned mission. And that's all for today. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell to stay updated on high-tech news. Peace to your home.